Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, my name is Muhammad Afizul Adin bin Lamrid. My metric number is B0818100099 and my supervisor is Puan Nur Bahirah binti Nurdin. Okay, today I want to present my PSM project. The title is Investigation of Horizontal Axis Wind Turbine Characteristic for Onshore Application. Okay, this is my introduction of my project. Okay, technology is gradually become more important in today's world, and particularly all technology is based on the utilization of energy. The use of electricity, particularly in non-renewable energy resource, has contributed to global warming, and almost every country in the world is now focusing on renewable energy as a main of preventing global warming, which has been occurring for more than a century. A wind turbine is a renewable energy source that obtains its power from the wind. Wind turbines are environmentally friendly since they use clean energy. So, in a comparison to other European countries, onshore wind energy investment and expansion is modern in Norway. So, the goal of this research was to create a portable horizontal axis wind turbine that could charge electronic devices like phone and power bank. Okay, this is a three problem statement of my project. First, the creation of a method supplying 5V DC electrical output. The second is the most efficient horizontal wind turbine design for onshore. So the lastly, as the number of people who use wind turbine for wind energy resource grow, the cost of wind turbine will decrease, allowing manufacturer to compete in the market. Okay, this is my project objective. So the first, to create a prototype for horizontal axis wind turbine with a 5V DC electrical output. And then I was to develop a tension mechanism for horizontal axis wind turbine that will generate DC voltage to charge a 12V DC battery. Okay, the lastly is to look into the design of a horizontal axis wind turbine that may be used in any onshore situation. The scope of this project is the wind turbine like will mean take advantage of wind energy that turn the kinetic energy to electrical energy. So wind turbine are used supplying energy and to generate modest amount of electricity for person use. For this project, we analyze the best performance of horizontal axis wind turbine exploitation and the wind speed that turbine encourage when the rotor situation as the height of the wind turbine can save more energy. Okay, this is a reference that I use for this project. So the first, the title is Wind Energy in the Built Environment. So the author is Hams 2012, and the techniques they use is the difference in the pressure between the top and the bottom of the blade cause a force to be applied to the top of the blade. Okay, the second is on critical aerolytic mode of a three rotor wind turbine. So the author is Oliver Tenders Filsoff 2021, and new wind turbine concept are updating to address the issue, with one of them be the creation of a multi-rotor wind turbine MRWT. Okay, for the third, the title is effect of vertexing of power output of vertical axis wind turbine VAWT. So the author is Amar Nasim 2020. So the double tube model which are employed to buy power, number of turbine blade, aspect ratio and wind speed as parameter is used to plan wind turbine. So next, the title is shape optimization of a seveniers with rotor with different converts and concave side. So the author is Meng Long Tian 2018, and the rotor consists of two or more protective stick fiberglass for metal rotor blade and a protective hub that rotated hence the name around a central axis. So the lastly of my reference is the title is DIY approach to a robust, accurate, low-cost wind turbine controller. So the title is Rockobuts 2017. So the technique they use is higher tower allow turbine to catch more energy and create more electricity as wind speeds increase. In general, as the height of the wind system rise, so does the output power and the turbulence in the winds. Okay, for the methodology, so this is my flowchart operation. Firstly, the program is start, and then wind energy supply to the blade, and blade is rotating to give a kinetic energy, and then the 12 volt DC motor generate the electricity for the buck boost converter. So the buck boost converter can step up the voltage from the rotation of blade, and then we can supply the energy to the battery rechargeable, and then after we charge the battery, so we can step down the voltage to the 5 volt using a voltage regulator, and then we can charge electrical gadget. So the end of my project for this operation. Okay, this is my list of equipment for this project. For the hardware, I use 12 volt DC motor to generate the electrical supply, and then I have a battery chargeable to store the energy from the DC motor, and then for the buck boost converter, they are used to step up the voltage, and then for the voltage regulator, I use give a 5 volt output DC motor to supply for our gadget. And then for the software, we use a Proteus 8 to simulate the circuit. And then for the design, I use AutoCAD 2031. Okay, this is my simulation circuit for buck boost converter. So buck boost converter is used to step up the voltage from 5 volts to 12 volts. So when the motor cannot generate a higher voltage, the buck boost converter can step up the voltage to charge the battery. Okay, this is a second circuit simulation. So this is a voltage regulator. So voltage regulator is used for give a 5 volt output to the supply for the gadget that use a USB cable. Okay, this is the initial result from me. They are use AutoCAD 2021 to design this wind turbine. So firstly, for the side view, show you about a blade, 12 volt DC motor. We have a tail, tower, and case, and lastly we have a foundation. So for the front view, this is a view of the horizontal axis wind turbine. The conclusion of my project is this study is focusing on the performance of horizontal axis wind turbine in categories of how much the voltage and current can be produced by the depending the speed of the wind. So this study also focusing on development of portable horizontal axis wind turbine that can be carried anywhere during a outdoor activity, and also can be used to charge any electronic gadget that use a 5 volt DC output USB charger. Okay, last but not least, this is my Gantt chart for this sem. So week 1 until week 2, I prepared my project proposal to give to supervisor. And then week 3 until week 5, I prepare for reference for literature review. And then week 3 until week 6, I create a design for this wind turbine. And then week 6 until week 7, week 9, I do a simulation of the circuit. So for week 8 until week 30, I prepare for the report writing. And then for the last week, week 14, I prepare for presentation PSM1 and submit report PSM1. So that's all from me. Thank you.